If people lose a hand, they have to overcome grief, loss of a body part, loss of a huge part of their life, and they have to learn to cope and influence the world around them with a reduced ability to function.
Even to do something simple like open an umbrella, you need a good functional hand, and that's something we have to do quite a lot of in Scotland.
What we'll see in the museum is a whole host of great ideas. Electrical artificial hands have had one gripping function. Our hand, because the individual fingers and thumb are able to move independently of each other, you can do virtually every grip that the human being chooses. The hand is controlled by using little electrical signals that the muscles generate when they contract. And how the hand is controlled is to harness these signals by placing electrodes over the skin, on the surface. The patenting process that we've gone through over the last 10 to 12 years has been vital to protecting the future of the ILM hand and making sure that the company could bring it to market. I think Patrick exemplifies the fact that if you give somebody the right tool, that they will use it in a very, very smart way.
It really has been revolutionary for not only my life, but for everyone who's received one of these arms, and it works so well, and it just really is life-changing.
There is a degree of huge satisfaction intellectually. There's a degree of human satisfaction about the fact that I spent my career trying to develop something which will actually benefit people, and it wasn't a theory, it was actually reality. And I think when you put that together, it gives you a huge degree of feel-good factor.